When we browse to our files, the files we can see and what we can do with them depend on both our role assignment and the access privileges assigned to us for each file. We can sort the files and folders here using any of the column headers. Content is organized so that our private files are available at the top level, with an icon beside each item to indicate its type, and additional notations to highlight files that are mobile-enabled or have been shared. Additional folders contain files shared with any team we belong to, any input forms created for planning activities, public files for which we're assigned read, delete, update, or full access privileges, and sample files. From the toolbar, we can create stories or digital boardroom agendas, provided we have the necessary permissions, create new folders, refresh the file list, upload other files, choose which column headers to display, apply filters to see only items of a specific type, choose to view all files, only files created by me, or only files shared with me, or search for content within any of the folders or subfolders. When we select a file, we can also edit the details for the file, move it, add it or remove it from the list of favorites, share it or adjust the sharing settings, copy it or delete it. We can also mark a file as a favorite by clicking the star icon. Any favorites are available on a separate tab. Note that when we delete a file, it's moved to the Deleted Files tab, where it remains for 30 days. From here, we can restore the deleted file if desired. Note that the file has been restored. If our user account includes administrative privileges, additional tabs are available to manage system objects, such as users and teams, and the content library. Refer to the videos on these topics for more details. Thanks for watching.